Hello, hello, welcome. Today I'm gonna do something I've been planning on doing for a while. I have this, well, thing. Someone painted the Dutch Railways logo on it. It's falling half apart, but it runs quite okay. And I have this, which I find a quite beautiful little engine, locomotive, which does nothing. So I'm gonna tear them apart, Frankenstein them, and hope to have one little cute running locomotive and one rather ugly thing to stand on the tracks somewhere. Gonna need spare parts for that. I also have this one here. These are both old Fleischmann trains, and they share a lot of the same parts, so I should be able to scavenge them and get this one up and running, because I like this one more than the other, so the others have to go. For a start, let's first open this thing up. I already took a peek inside, and I have sort of a clue on what's missing, so I'm rather confident I can pull this one off. If I can open them. Task number one, remove screws. Oh, there we go, that's the top. I'm gonna move that apart off my workbench a bit. There we go. That's the frame. I'm gonna get rid of that as well. Set the screws. Getting rid of those. So, what is missing is the three gears that go in here. The fourth gear that goes behind here. And the electrical wiring between the bottom plate and the motor shield. Now, what do I have here? The electrical wire coming from here to the motor shield. The motor shield itself with all the components that this one is missing. Brushes, springs, but this one's missing those as well. And the plate to cover up the gears and all four gears. So if I would need anything from this, it would be this. No, not that either. That's just dropping out. So yeah, probably this little piece of metal plate that would go right behind there. That's a good start. This is probably gonna jump away to be lost forever. But if not, it should go a bit lower than this. Will it go a bit? It is the correct size. But maybe this is just worn out. Right, now. Replacement of the first part. Unsuccessful. Let's get down to the rest. This is still running quite nice. Screws are just falling out at random. That's also good. Let's get rid of this one. Okay. The bottom shield reveals the pickup mechanism I'm going to try to get the motor shield from here. And at the same time, keep the brushes and springs in there. Oh, this one's a tight one. I know I have opened it before because I replaced some parts in a previous episode. Missing one brush. Here it is. In that case. Oh, something went wrong here with putting the cap on. One motor shield. This I'm not going to use. Here's one of the gears. That's another one. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, this is gonna be so fun getting those in. If I can't get them out, let's first try to get these in. I can always get the big ones out, but rather not. I'd rather just roll them in like this, put them sort of in place, and then just start rolling the gears until it goes to a spot where I want to actually have it. But instead, this one's getting loose. Okay, getting my head out of the way. Right, easy task, huh? Sorry, I'm moving out of view, but this is not going anywhere I'm here where it should be going. Ah, there we go, that's one. That's two. Ring back on. That's one wheel moving. Now get rid of these gears here. What I'm doing is I'm lifting this big one here. That should, let me repeat, should give me enough room to get the small one out. That makes this move freely, so then I can just get my screwdriver under here, try to get through the hole, Since these are plastic, they bend a bit. There we go. Now over here, I'm first going to do the corner. Then I'm going to do the center, and I'm hoping they fit. Lovely, lovely. They actually fit. I'm very happy with that. Okay. That's one part. Part two. Replacing the shield with the shield from the other one. Hoping to get the right screws in here and give it a go. Getting rid of this stuff on the bottom. I'm hoping that one will fit. That would be nice. That's the old stuff. I kind of like how they built these little, these really old engines and these motors, and how you can take them apart quite easily. That's why I also like the Lima trains. They are so easy to break, repair, and take apart. And oh, that's a shame. I was hoping that the layout would be the same, but it isn't. Oh no, that's too bad. They changed it around a bit. Now I have to do some soldering. But seems something else is wrong as well. Okay, it has fallen apart. But that's... Nope, nope. Oh, they changed the shield around a bit. I'll have to reuse the old one. And in that case, I must desolder the. This is a coil. That's its purpose is to suppress some noise. Maybe I can lift this whole. No. So I have to get. I have to try to transfer the coil, which is. Is that going to be tricky? If doable at all. And then I have to solder the other wires, which just snapped off, which is also a coil, and it should be a... Well, this is being a bit more complicated than I was hoping. But the coils are mainly for suppressing noise, so you you can play with your trains and the neighbors can still watch TV. I'm just going to see what this stuff is. If I can get this stuff off. Oh, it smells like old electronics. It smells like grease. It smells like old solder. This is not moving. I'm gonna get back to. I'm gonna stop the video and get back if I figured out how to get this part off and onto the other motor shield. So be right back. So I soldered the. Must be the capacitor back on, and I also soldered the power connector to pick up the power from the wheels back on, because that dropped off in the process. And I hope I did it correctly. Yes, indeed, and it fits right in. So it's, I'm gonna just make sure it stays in place by getting some of the screws in. That was some interesting soldering, because oh, this one's not, it's not good. No, there's another good screw. If it's the screw, I hope it is the screw and it's not the terrain. If it's the frame of the train, then it's the frame. Darn it. I hope I can get some screws that will actually grip onto it, onto the frame. This one has been opened and closed so many times. All the screws are... Yeah, you can, there's no way you can fix them in the frame, because they won't grip. Now, where are the correct screws? You are not correct either. And are you? I believe this is already a Frankenstein engine. So I did some soldering, put the capacitor back on, put the coil back on and the bottom here, but I'm starting to believe this is already a Frankenstein engine. So I did some soldering, I put the capacitor back on and the coil and the part to pick up the power. But I believe this is already a Frankenstein motor, because I noticed when putting it back together it's got a slight... the frame seems to be a bit too thick for the bottom part of the motor itself. And when I try to get the screws in, I notice that they won't grip. I don't have screws that are long enough to go all the way in and to grip into the metal here. So that's, to me, a sign that someone has already been playing around with this motor and didn't successfully complete the job. So I'm looking through my my leftover screws I have here. Maybe also from this, in the hopes that I find one that's a bit longer, so I can get it all back together again. Maybe this one is a bit longer, but I think it's all exactly the same. No. If only one would have some grips, then at least it would get me somewhere. No, it's just... You can feel it slipping, it is in here, but not quite. Nope, same here, it's not gripping onto the screw, the this one is sort of... It's gonna be a bit of trial and error, I think. That's a shame. Maybe I'll have to... That one's gripping now as well. Maybe I'll have to sand down something, but... Sanding down steel is not my favorite hobby of the day. I think it would be easier to get longer screws. Okay, I got three that gripped, sort of. It means this one... I have to pull it slightly to get to the bottom. So, okay... Get here, yes, that fits perfectly. And then the shield that goes on top and shields the... This... The gears, this little, come on. That's better. It helps if you have it in the correct position. Get this in. Okay, now I have one brush. I have one brush with a spring. And I have one spring. And I have some caps. Okay. Now let's see if this still wants to. One still wants to move. I think it needs some oiling. But it is moving. So let me just quickly get this into place here. Never touching those screws again, I hope. In the body of this train is all the extra weight, so it's not making a proper contact with the... Get back here. It's not making proper contact now with the rails. And I think the wheels need cleaning. Yeah, the wheels do need some cleaning. But that's for a later bit. I am very happy. It's smelling horrible, so it's running. I'm gonna put it back together. I'm gonna stop filming. Be done for today. And have a new locomotive. I think is much prettier than the other two that I used the parts of, and that makes me happy. So I hope you enjoyed this creation of a Frankenstein Fleischmann, getting it up and running from scrap I got from all over the place. And I hope to get this one, give this one a nice place somewhere in my hopefully to build track someday. Oh, it works! It's alive again! Thanks for watching, and if you like this, just like the video, subscribe to my videos, share it with friends, share it on Facebook. And I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.